Hello everyone, welcome to this video thing. Today we're going to be talking about the working titles of Doctor Who.
Indeed we are.
Yes.
So there's a lot to get through. And,
we've gone for a lot more laid back, approach.
Yeah.
Because comfort.
Yes. So,
how far do these go back? I take it there's
1963.
Okay, I take it there isn't one for every story.
There's not one for every story.
Yeah.
There's one for a lot of them.
Okay.
Like, I think it's more than half.
Mm.
And we also have some for K-9 and Company, Torchwood, and Class, as well as some novels and a couple of audio stories, not many.
Okay.
So we could just go through the TARDIS wiki page, like the entire page, or...
I think we should just go through the Doctor Who ones, because I...
No spin-offs, no expanded media, just Doctor Who.
Yeah, because I feel like there's a... Didn't you say there was like 100 odd Doctor Who ones to get through?
Yeah, that's most of the page.
Yeah, we don't just want to like... make this in a wrong video.
Yeah. So, the first four stories of Season 1... 1963 to 1964 have working titles. An Unearthly Child, well actually the first three are ones you may have heard of, including you audience. So An Unearthly Child, which is what the story's generally called.
Yeah.
Because a lot of these early stories are serialized and don't actually have overall story titles in broadcast, sometimes in other official material it can be referred to as something else. So for An Earthly Child, working titles are 100,000 BC and The Tribe of Gum, which you may have heard of.
Yeah, I think I have.
Same thing with The Daleks, as it can be, its working titles are The Dead Planet, Beyond the Sun,
what about that one?
And The Mutants.
Yeah.
Now, The Mutants is something, like,
that's still up for debate. People still, like, call it that.
Yeah, because I'm pretty sure in the, Complete History series, they call An Unearthly Child 100,000 BC. And they call the Daleks the Mutants.
Mm.
But why would you call it the Mutants retroactively?
I don't know.
When the Mutants is a Pertwee story.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense.
Yeah.
I didn't think about that.
Yeah.
I almost forget about The Mutants.
The Edge of Destruction was going to be called Inside the Spaceship. Makes sense.
It makes sense.
It is a bit...
the best title, though.
Yeah, but then again, Edge of Destruction's kind of vague.
Yeah.
But so is Inside the Spaceship.
Yeah, I suppose, yeah. One just sounds cooler.
Yeah. Now, Marco Polo has a title that I think is equally as good. It's just less... descriptive.
Okay.
A Journey to Cathay.
Okay.
Because that's what the story is.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I mean, that's what the story is, but I say it's less descriptive because when you hear that it's called Marco Polo, you're expecting Marco Polo.
Yeah, exactly.
So, I do feel Marco Polo is the better choice. Season 2 has a few more. Planet of Giants. Death in the Afternoon.
Okay.
And The Minuscules.
I feel like that.
The Minuscules is probably better than Planet of Giants, because Planet of Giants is a bit misleading.
Yeah, true, yeah.
Yeah, I always got a bit confused. Although, I wonder if one of them was a title of an episode, because it was going to be 4 episodes. But then they cut it down to 3.
Maybe.
So, whoever's editing, do the research. The Dark Invasion of Earth. You'll laugh at this one. The Daleks.
Great.
I mean, fair, but I think if you're going to call any story the Daleks,
Well, you already had the Daleks.
Well,
this
yeah.
is their second Dalek story, so call
yeah,
it
Yeah, but
Daleks.
I don't think they called it. I don't think they were bothering with calling it that at that point.
Yeah, they just went as Daleks in it. We'll put that in the. Yeah, that was just the like, script holder or something.
Yeah.
Which one was it?
Yeah, and part two is called The Daleks. So. The Crusade. The Sarakin hordes, or the Saracen hordes, Saracen hordes.
I was like, yeah, what does that even mean?
Saracen hordes, Saracens, there's hordes of them.
Yeah, it's not the best title.
The Crusade is
yeah
better.
Crusade's quite a good.
Because you know it's about the Crusades.
Yeah.
The Web Planet, here's one that could have worked. The Zarbi.
Yeah, that works.
I think The Web Planet is a better title.
Yeah.
But Zarbi works. Mm. I mean, that's what the novelization is called, Watching the Zarbi.
Mm-hmm.
The Chase. The Pursuers.
That works.
That works just as well.
Yeah.
The Time Meddler. The Monk.
That works. The Time Meddler is killer, though.
Yeah. Yeah.
That leaves, like, intrigue as well, for your movie.
Although it is a twist that he... although they're building suspense that, oh, these things are... Like, yeah, you know the story, like, building
yeah.
suspense about all these artifacts that are from the future. Why
yeah.
are they back in 1066?
Yeah.
And then... Yeah. I think... Right, season three... We go to the Celestial Toymaker, which, bad for racism. To be honest, one of the working titles was just the Toymaker.
That's fine.
Yeah. That's what I call it.
Most people do, yeah.
Like, the C word isn't meant to be a slur
yeah.
from a writing point of view, it's just the production design just made it racist.
Yeah.
And then there's also the Trilogic game, because, to be honest, I don't think that's good, because that's just one aspect of the plot of that story, where the Doctor's doing the Trilogic game.
I suppose.
Yeah. Yeah. The Gunfighters could have been called the Gunslingers.
Yeah, I think I've heard that one.
And the War Machines could have been called the Computers.
I quite like that.
Yeah, I'd be fine with that.
Yeah.
Yeah, because that's what it's playing on. Okay, the Power of the Daleks could have been called the Destiny of Doctor Who.
Oh no, that wouldn't have been good.
Yeah. Oh, here's one. Here's this one that I showed you earlier. The Macro Terror could have been called the Spider-Men, or the Insect-Men.
That's worse.
But they probably changed it to crabs later on in development, so they called it the Macro.
Yeah, that's... yeah. Because even if they hadn't, like, even the Spider Terror would be better than, like, the Spider-Men.
And the faceless ones could have been called the chameleons.
Yeah,
I mean, this is at a time where, well, now it's got the overall title.
Okay.
So we can't blame it on, oh, this could have been an individual episode.
Yeah, title. That's a good title for that.
By the way, individual episode titles did exist for Planet of the Daleks, so if you want to look at that soon, I think it might have existed for Revenge of the Cybermen.
Why,
I think we'll get.
Why did they do that? Why did they bring it back?
Or
just for a little.
Because Terry Nation didn't know.
Oh. What? No,
and
why?
For Revenge of the Cybermen, I think Jerry Davis didn't know either.
Why didn't? Surely the person in production would have been like.
I think they would have thought they didn't need to know because they've been doing it for years.
I guess. Yeah. It just seems odd to them.
Because back when they were working for the show. Yeah, I mean, although Jerry Davis, I don't think would make that much sense. I think it might have just been Terry Nation.
I mean, because it would have been like a really quick fix as well, like literally before it goes out, it's like, oh yeah, by the way, just
call it something else.
Yeah.
Planet of the Duck. You know. But we'll get to that when we get to season 10. So season 5, which is, there's going to be a gap between seasons from here on out. Season 5, Fury from the Deep, could have been called The Colony of Devils.
Sorry?
I mean, I guess it's focusing on the human aspect of it.
Yeah, I'd imagine so, yeah.
Even though...
Fury from the Deep,
Fury from the Deep is more so psychological horror, though.
Yeah.
That's why Fury from the Deep works better as a title.
Shame it's shit.
It's not. It's not shit. The animation's shit.
Okay, well, like, the reconstruction, like, DVD is shit.
Yeah.
That's what I mean.
Animation shit, but the story's actually good. So season 8, The Claws of Axos was originally going to be called The Vampire from Space. And if you have the season 8 Blu-ray, you'll know this.
I did?
Yes, because there's a bonus feature where there's like an original edit of episode 1, where it was still called The Vampire from Space. I've not seen it either. But it's on there.
I wonder if it was different.
Yeah. Or I might have been describing the feature wrong, but yeah. Season 9. So Day of the Daleks had 2 working titles according to this. But
okay.
There may have been more, of course. That's for all of these. That's for even stories we've not discussed. But The Ghost Hunters, which makes sense based on the plot, and Years of Doom, again, makes sense.
Yeah.
But you kind of have to say of the Daleks if you're bringing the Daleks back.
I suppose, yeah. Like, would that become a thing at that point? Or there was that...
Blank of the Daleks.
Oh, yeah, I guess Power of the Daleks.
Yeah, Power of the Daleks, Evil of the Daleks.
Yeah.
I think those are the only of the Daleks titles. I mean, there's Dalek Invasion of Earth. And Dalek's Master Plan.
Yeah, I know.
But, yeah. Day of the Daleks. It's the first Dalek story that has of the Daleks that doesn't begin with the.
Okay.
But, yeah. I mean, Day of the Daleks makes a lot of sense because it's about a certain day.
Yeah.
So, yeah. And then the Sea Devils was going to be called the Sea Silurians.
Oh. Yeah, that's not a great
That's kind of dumb.
Yeah, that's kind of bad.
Sea Silurians! My favourite story! So, I mean, that's... Okay, let's have a look at Planet of the Daleks' individual titles. Hold on, let me just... I'm going to try and get it up, but Tardisoki's getting hard to manoeuvre around.
That is fine.
I see what you're doing.
So, if this is the same one, then... Oh, wait, what? I thought this was the one for my review, but it had come out.
Oh.
I guess it's not. I don't know what I did with the old one. I gave both of them away. I had 2. One with the head came off, and then another one for some reason.
You lied to me all these years. I thought this one was the one with the head coming off.
Well, apparently not. Maybe Ollie is the old one.
Maybe. Anyway,
because I wanted to put it on the cyber one.
Right, so... No. Don't you fucking dare.
Cyberwoman wants to hug Kerr. Because she is thematically deep.
Right, so here are the original names. The first title would have been called Destinus. That was going to be the... That was going to be the name of the planet.
Oh.
So...
Yeah, that makes sense then.
And then Mission Survival was part 2. Part 3 was going to be called Pursued. Part 4 was going to be called Escape or Die. Part 5 was going to be called The Day Before Eternity. And part 6 was going to be called Victory.
They were all right, to be fair.
Yeah, they're very Terminator, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. I'm looking at the story notes, and it says at one point in development, the story had a working title, Destination Daleks. But that's not on this TARDIS wiki page.
Okay.
For a list of working titles.
Interesting.
TARDIS wiki, get on it.
I quite like, yeah.
We're just going through this page, we're not going to go through every single story and look at the notes that we picked too far.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, obviously not. But I would say that would have been an alright title, so yeah, I'd like that.
Destination Dark.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would have been better than Planet with Daleks.
Yeah.
Season 11, the only one on this page, is Death of the Daleks. And it would have been called the Exelons, but there's two different spellings. There's one with one X and one with two X's.
How was it actually spelled? What's the in canon? Not that it matters. You don't have to look up.
Two X's.
Okay. I mean, yeah, that works.
The production code was XXX, so they should have made it three X's. Exelon!
Wow.
Season 14, The Mask of Mandragora. Could have been called The Catacombs of Death, The Curse of Mandragora, and The Secret and Secret of the Labyrinth.
They're all actually good titles.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like all of those.
I like Curse of Mandragora. I mean, The Mask of Mandragora, because there's a mask. There's masquerade.
Yeah. Yeah.
And The Talons of Wang Chiang was originally going to be called Foe from the Future.
Okay.
Probably as a leftover from the fact that they were originally going to have a story called Foe from the Future. And there's going to be an element taken from that, i.e. the main villain was going to be a Foe from the Future, and that ended up being Magnus Greel.
Oh.
Although I think it was, Robert Holmes originally wanted it to be the Master.
Yeah, 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 you told me that, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Crispy Boy.
Yeah. And, but then, they dropped it and they nearly called it the Talons of Greel.
Which still works, I suppose.
Yeah, but I think Wang Chiang,
yeah, Wang Chiang
emphasises Chiang. The Chinese influence,
yeah,
of the story. Racism. Horror of Fang Rock could have been called Rocks of Doom.
Yeah, that's not a great title.
And then the Monster of Fang Rock and the Beast of Fang Rock. Probably because they wanted to emphasize the rootin'.
I think the Monster of Fang Rock's alright.
Yeah. In season 16, the Stones of Blood could have been called the Nine Maidens. Which could have worked, because that's what the stone arrangement is. And also, Stones of Time.
Okay.
But I don't think they're that.
Yeah.
No.
So the Blood's the best type of those.
Power of Kroll could have been called Moon of Death. Which kind of makes sense, because they're on the third moon of Delta Magna.
Okay, I've not seen it in a while, so I wouldn't remember
that. The Horror of the Swamp. And the Shield of Time.
Why the
Shield? I have a feeling both Stones of Time and Shield of Time may have been to do with the fact that these are to do with the segments of each time.
Oh. So do you think, so is everyone going to have like an off-time?
Maybe. Period? Maybe, but those were the two Season 16 stories on this list. Season 17. So Eve Death was originally going to be called The Time of Sephiroth. One Winged Angel should play here. But dun, 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 dun. You know, One Winged Angel. And this is something I knew, it also had the working title of A Gamble with Time, because there was going to be a gambling subplot in there.
Okay.
But then Douglas Adams was like, no. And David Fisher was like, I can't write more of this. And Douglas Adams is like, Graham, we've got a weekend.
They pretty much already have, like...
Let's go to Paris. Nightmare of Eden could have been called Nightmare of Evil.
Okay.
And Sharda could have been called Sunburst.
Why?
I like that it's called Sharda.
Yeah.
Because it's It's Shada is just so fun to say. Okay.
Sunburst. it just kind of takes away any of the seriousness of the story.
Yeah. Season 18, Meglos could have been called the Golden Pentangle.
Okay.
Well, they're worshipping this
polygon
thing.
I remember.
The Golden Pentagram.
That's better than that.
The Last Solfataran, or Solfataran.
Don't know what that is.
I think that might have been the original title of Solfathura.
Oh.
And they called it, and then there was the Last Solfathuran.
Okay.
Because that's Meglos. So they just called it Meglos because it's simpler.
Yeah.
Because you could tell that the less focus was to the item of worship that Meglos was after, and they were wanting to focus more and more on Meglos. Which is fine. Too bad Meglos is shit. And then Sailor Decay, which isn't shit. The vampire mutations, which kind of gives it away, because that's a twist. And the wasting.
Which
I like State of Decay and Wasting.
Yeah.
I think State of Decay is a really cool title based on the story.
Yeah, State of Decay is a good title.
Yeah. And also, when you realise why it's called that, you're like, ooh, that's good. I actually like it. That's the feeling I would have wanted throughout Season 18.
Yeah.
But that's like the peak. But for the idea Season 18 was going for, it needed to be that constantly rather than that be the peak.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, Season 19, okay. The Visitation was originally going to be called Invasion of the Plague Men.
That's not the...
Or Plague Rats.
That's not catchy either.
The Visitation's better.
Yeah, The Visitation.
Even
The Visitation's just a good title.
Yeah, yeah, because I explained it to you this morning.
Yeah, you explained it to me earlier.
Yeah. About how, the plague was called The Visitation.
Yeah.
And also being visited by aliens.
Double meaning.
Earthshock could have been called Sentinel. And Time Flight was either going to be called Xanadin or Xerathin. I think that would have been... I think they were going through naming the Xerathin Gestalt.
Okay.
With that. But then Time Flight, because it's a flight through time! They should have just called it Kali the Great. Next. So Season 21, the Kip... I'm surprised the Five Doctors isn't here, because it was originally going to be called the Sixth Doctors. But it was also originally going to be written by Bob Holmes, so I think
that's
a different story.
It was going to be the other
Robot First Doctor.
I've heard about this, but I don't know anything about it.
All I know is that it would have been written by Robert Holmes.
That would have been good.
It would have been interesting.
Yeah.
But I'm kind of glad we've got the Five Doctors.
What the fuck would Robot First Doctor be?
The villain!
Would he just pretend to the other doctor, hey, it's me, the Doctor!
I think so! Speaking of Bob Holmes, Season 21, the Caves Around Design could have been called Chain Reaction.
What? Yeah,
that. Yeah. But the Caves Around Design.
Yeah.
I just wouldn't want it changed.
Me neither, it's a good title.
Ooh. Two Doctors was originally going to be called the Kraglon Inheritance. But then it was going to be called the Androgum Inheritance. You know, looking at these titles, it's clear that many writers have gone through name changes of
Yeah,
because that looks like the Androgums were originally going to be called Kraglons.
Listen,
if I'm wrong, can I just say, if I'm ever wrong, please don't cringe, please correct me, and just accept that I'm wrong. But if I'm not, shush.
I'm right about everything, that's fine.
Revelation of the Daleks could have been called The End of the Road, which kind of makes sense because of Necros.
Yes.
That makes sense.
But obviously, the Of the Daleks tales had stuck by this point.
Yeah. Season 23. The Ultimate Foe was originally going to be called Time Incorporated. No.
Yeah.
No.
That's not great.
That's dumb, Mr. Holmes. Like, I know you died midway through writing this, but, like, no. I'm gonna be grueling about this decision. No, but may you rest in peace. Rest in peace, Bob Holmes.
Yes.
Okay, here's one you may have heard of. Time of the Rani. Strange Matter.
Yeah, I've heard about that one.
Yeah.
I quite like it.
But Delta and the Baron was originally going to be called Flight of the Shimmerong.
Quite like that too.
Mm-hmm.
Like Delta and the Bannerman, I don't know, that is like a good feel to it though.
Yeah.
I think that fits the story better.
Okay, yeah, because it gives off a vibe.
Yeah.
In a way. Dragonfire was originally going to be called Absolute Zero. Which makes sense because Ice World and Kane and being frozen and all that. Or the Pyramid's Treasure. I don't remember a pyramid in Dragonfire, but it's been a while since I last saw it.
Me neither.
And also Pyramid in Space. So they were really going for this pyramid if it did exist.
Wait, so the actual, like, place where, like, they meet, where, like, Ace gets there, is that on a pyramid?
I don't know.
I assume it must
be. I don't know.
I assume it must be if there's all this pyramid.
The season 24 Blu-ray is coming out soon.
Yeah.
Might as well find out. Right, season 25, The Happiness Patrol was originally going to be called The Crooked Smile.
I quite like that.
Yeah.
That fits the tone of the story as well.
Yeah.
Happiness Patrol is a good title too, though.
Also, like
Crooked Smile.
And to be honest, the Candyman's original design would have actually complemented that.
What was? Oh, did he have a crooked smile? Was it? Like,
it was like ravenous.
Oh.
Yeah. He's got a crooked smile, and the smiles are disingenuous and crooked in Happiness Patrol. Mm. That would have really worked. Happiness Patrol works because that's the name of the antagonists. And that's fine. The Crooked Smile would be brilliant, though.
Oh yeah, that would have been really good.
Yeah.
It's just weird how the original design for the candy, how different it is.
Yeah, but J&T wanted a lawsuit.
Yeah.
yeah, the Candyman's actual design is all J&T's fault.
That Bertie Bassett guy's kind of cool.
Let's do that, but again.
Yeah.
The Happiness Patrol.
Yeah.
It's a good story, guys.
What about it?
Happiness shall prevail.
And then it will go away.
Yeah. Silver Nemesis was originally just going to be called Nemesis.
Yeah, you told me that one earlier.
And that is fair.
I guess it doesn't give away that Cybermen are in it. That way.
Yeah, and also it means it's more about Nemesis.
Yeah, so I think Silver Nemesis are better.
I think Silver Nemesis, well, Nemesis himself is, or itself, herself, themself.
The thing is, Nemesis focuses more on Nemesis, but the title Silver Nemesis, you think that it's just the Cybermen.
Yeah, but the Cybermen are a twist.
That is true. Yeah, good point. Yeah.
Because I think the logic was, it's going to be their Silver Anniversary, let's throw in the Cybermen, and then say Silver Nemesis, even though they're a bloody twist. I think it could have been a J&T decision.
Probably is.
Yeah.
Well,
like
weird decision. Yeah,
it's weird, like season 25 still feels like J&T has some holes, but he's starting to give up, and season 26 he's like, Andrew,
oh,
you do
it.
Half an hour.
Because that only records for half an hour. And it's still going, 29 minutes 40.
Yeah. So we're like 25 years
old.
Yeah. Oh boy, so. So yeah, we're 25 seasons in. Season 26, all four of them had working titles. Battlefield, Nightfall.
I've actually heard that one.
Yeah, but I think Nightfall was a title of another story Ben Abramovich was trying to write.
Okay.
But this one is spelled with no space, but it's night as in nighttime.
Oh.
Not like.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's weird. And then also Storm Over Avalon.
Okay.
Huh. nothing at all like Battlefield. Okay, I've got to be careful with one of Ghostlight's names. The Bestiary.
Right.
The Bestiary. Because, I mean, Light's trying to have a menagerie of, like, or collecting data on, like, every living thing.
Yes.
So that kind of makes sense. And also some of the stuff that happens in Ghostlight, that makes sense.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Curse of... Actually, no, wait. Ghostlight also had the title of Life Cycle. Which also makes sense.
Yeah.
Honestly, that works better because that's more to do with the plot. Because Ghostlight...
I think literally Ghostlight just sounds cooler.
Yeah, Ghostlight sounds cool.
On a cover, you're like, oh.
Yeah, but like, the thing is with Ghostlight, that's a reference to Light, who only shows up in like part 3.
True.
Of this three-parter. The Curse of Fenric. Wolf time. we'll be happy. Wolf time. And then it was also going to be called The Wolves of Fenric. Which makes just as much sense as The Curse of Fenric.
It makes sense, but I just...
Based on the story
I don't think it's as good a title, though.
Curse of Fenric. Yeah, it feels more like a classic title. But, like, The Wolves of Fenric makes sense based on what's actually... What the story's about.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Survival. Cat Flap.
Oh, yeah.
Blood Hunt.
Okay.
And The Survival.
Alright.
But Survival, you know, just shortening it to that, I think. To be honest, I feel like the more I think about Survival, the more I'm like, it's kind of like the perfect ending. But I should save my simping. Dimensions in Time!
Oh.
It's here, so why not? It's on this list. It was originally going to be called The Dimensions of Time.
Okay.
The Dimensions of Time, and Three Dimensions of Time. Because it's in 3D!
Nah, that's an awful title.
J&T fucking wrote it. Like, he co-wrote Dimensions in Time.
Yeah.
So, that is a very J&T thing to do. New Who.
Okay. I feel like I'll know some of these, especially later on, because... Well, yeah.
Series 1 has quite a few. Rose Meets the Doctor. I don't think any of these were meant to be the final title.
Okay. Yeah, didn't you say a lot of
these are working titles.
Yeah, they're more so this is what happens in the story.
Well, yeah. Like, this is more so getting the vibe of the story, like Rose Meets the Doctor.
I feel like Aliens in London would have been one of them, but they just kept it.
Yeah, because it quite worked.
Yeah.
The Unquiet Dead. My name's Chicken. Chickens?
What?
Oh, yeah. No, my name's Dickens. Charles Dickens.
Yeah.
My name's Chickens.
I quite like that tale.
Yeah. But I think they were trying to focus on the ghosts.
Yeah.
Because the way New Who's marketed is very different to how Classic Who's marketed. And with New Who, it's like, you have the Next Time trailer. And it may have, like, more prominent magazine representation. So you'll see, like, Charles Dickens everywhere.
Played by
Simon Cowell.
Yeah. They're quite dead, it's a cool title anyway.
Yeah. And then there's also the Crippingwell Horror and the Angels of Crippingwell.
I like those as well.
Yeah. World War III was originally going to be called 10 Downing Street.
Alright.
Because that's what it's predominantly said.
Yeah, that works, but I don't think, what you were saying about New Who, it doesn't really capture. I don't think it...
World War III, I never really liked that as a title.
I don't like it that much either. But I think it's...
This is why if they ever make a novelization of it, I want them to call it Doctor in the Slovene.
Yeah.
Because that's just,
I mean, they could just, like... If it's because it's a two-part, they could just call the whole thing.
But they could also call it Doctor in the Slovene.
Yeah, which works.
Yeah. Dalek. there's Return of the Daleks.
Sorry.
Creature of Lies. And Absence of the Daleks.
Okay.
Which could have been a working title if they weren't able to have the Daleks, or but it also works as it's not really.
I thought they would have called like, I thought one of them would be like Metal Tron or something like that.
Maybe, but I think this is a tightened thing. The Long Game, The Companion Who Couldn't.
I like that.
Yeah, because I guess it's to emphasize how it emphasizes Adam.
Yeah.
But the plot surrounding it was probably something RTD had, like, since the 90s. Father's Day, Wounded Time.
It makes sense.
Yeah.
Father's Day.
Father's Day seems more personal, and that's what... Because the thing is, the RTD era is the one with, like, you've got to really focus on the emotional aspect of it, especially in regards to the characters, and hence why you call the first episode Rose.
Yeah.
And whether you like it or not, I personally come around to think, okay, yeah, this is a good direction for the show.
Yeah. It's clever, but it's also the main point as well.
Yeah.
It's like, it's a snappy tale. It's clever and it all ties.
Yeah, and Father's Day, it's about that Rose's dad.
Yeah.
And it's about the day he died. The Empty Child could have been called An Empty Child, and World War II.
Okay.
And the Doctor the Doctor Dances could have been called Captain Jacks, because Captain Jack was originally going to be called Captain Jacks.
Oh.
J-A-X.
I mean, I feel like all three of the titles aren't the best.
The like, Empty Child is better than
Child. The Empty Child. I was on about
the
why the Doctor Dances. I bet not even that's a great title, because it was just Moffat being like, hey guys,
it's the Doctor having sex! Yeah, because originally I'm just like, the Doctor Dances, that's a kind of anticlimactic title. And then when I realise, oh shit, dancing is a sexual metaphor. Now I just hate the title because Stephen Moffat's just like, the Doctor fucks.
Yeah.
No. Boomtown was originally going to be called Dining with Monsters.
I've heard that and I like that.
And I like how it's monsters plural. Because you may think, wait, there's only one monster there, Margaret.
But it has Mickey and Jack.
Fuck off. No, I was meaning the Doctor. The Doctor's the monster there, because Time War...
Yeah.
That... Yeah. But again, that's focusing on more one aspect of the plot. Although Boomtown feels more like a bait and switch.
Yeah, true.
And I like that. And then Bad Wolf was originally going to be called Game Show World. Yeah.
It sure is!
Yeah.
That's all I can really say about that.
Calling it Bad Wolf makes sense, because it's like, this is the finale,
yeah,
this is where you should start paying attention.
Yeah. That thing we've been alluding to is finally
coming
to.
Series 2, New Earth, was going to be called Body Swap in one stage of development.
That works.
It's fine. Yeah, but I feel like calling it New Earth makes sense, because it's enticing us with not only, well, for people who didn't see Series 1, it's enticing viewers with the idea of a new Earth.
Yeah.
But
it's also a fresh start for a new Doctor.
Uh-huh. Hence why you could have the opening scene with new Doctor.
Mm-hmm.
But also, New Earth, if you were paying attention to End of the World, it's telling you it's a sequel, but, you know, it's clever. Too bad it's shit!
Yeah.
Tooth and Claw could have been called Queen Victoria.
Again, it works.
Bit on the nose,
yeah.
But it works. I think it works. But Tooth and Claw, yeah, because like Tooth and Nail, Tooth and Claw.
And Werewolf.
Ah, woo. School Reunion could have been called Old Friends or Black Ops.
I don't get that one.
I don't get that one. Mr. Whithouse? Mr. Davies? Can you explain that one, please? around the fireplace. Could be called Madame de Pompadour.
Yeah.
Which would have worked. Or every tick of my heart.
That works. A bit cheesy, though.
It's a bit cheesy. Steve Moffat, remember?
Yeah.
But it works. And then Renette and the Lonely Angel.
Again, it's a bit Tumblr, isn't it?
Yeah. Because that whole episode is a bit Tumblr. It's good.
Yeah.
It's really good. I honestly think it would be a 10 out of 10 if I didn't see it as a bit noncy, because I can't unsee that now, but it doesn't affect my enjoyment too much.
Okay.
It's still a really good episode. Whereas the Cybermen Age of Steel, now both of them are being categorized because originally, because you can see there's photo evidence of Tom McRae holding the script,
mm-hmm.
where it was like Parallel World Part 1 and Parallel World Part 2. Parallel World could have worked.
Yeah.
But Cyber Boys!
Stompy Rompies.
The Idiot's Lantern could have been called Mr. Sandman.
Okay.
Or Sonic Doom.
Right.
Or One-Eyed Monster. One-Eyed Monster makes the most sense, because television.
I think One-Eyed Monster was the one that I had heard, because I think Mark Gatiss like tweeted out like something about like running tables for themselves.
But why Mr. Sandman?
Yeah,
unless if he was planning Sleep No More this early. For all we know, he could have been.
I guess. Maybe?
Or maybe the taking of the face is putting you to sleep?
Possibly. I don't know, it probably would have been a different
Sonic
story.
Doom makes no sense. I don't have any.
Yeah.
Possible Planet Satan Pit was originally going to be called Satan Pit. And Love and Monsters could have been called I Love the Doctor.
Okay.
Which I'm fine with.
Yeah.
But I would have preferred that, actually. Because that's more so what the episode's about.
I suppose.
Fandom. You know?
Yeah.
Fear her. Chloe Weber destroys the world. That's not even the most what the fuck.
Sounds like an awful like Disney kid show.
Either that or a really good Netflix original. Bad Disney or good Netflix. Take your pick. But here's the other one. You're a bad girl, Chloe Weber.
Coming to hurt you.
We should laugh about that. That's an abusive father.
Yeah. We do not stand abuse.
We do not. Army of Ghosts could have been called Tortured Rises, and Doomsday could have been called Tortured Falls.
Yeah, I've heard those two.
Yeah.
I like them both.
I like them both.
I do think
I'm fine with.
I think Doomsday makes more sense as in like for the end for a companion though. Because I feel like
with the emotional impact that has, and then Army of Ghosts,
it just sounds cool.
It's just the literal thing.
Yeah.
I think what I have a feeling, Tortured Rises, Tortured Falls, that could have worked. But then as soon as Russell T Davies thought of Doomsday, he's like, ah, oh, fuck.
Yeah.
What do I call the other one? I'll call it this one. Sounds good.
Mm-hmm.
Smith and Jones may not surprise you. It could have just been called Martha.
Yeah, I do think that.
But he really likes the Smith and Jones thing. Shakespeare Code could have been called Love Labours One.
Yeah.
Because that's what it's about.
That would have been fine as well.
That would have been really good.
Yeah.
And Theatre of Death.
Yeah, that's fine.
That sounds very Tom Baker.
Yeah.
Makes sense knowing the writer's history. The writer who we will not name.
Mm-hmm.
Lazarus Experiment could have been called The Madness of Professor Lazarus. Lazarus Experiment is more concise.
Yeah.
Because I like both titles. I like the other title more, but it's like,
oh,
Lazarus is more concise. So I get it. Blink could have been called Sally Sparrow and the Weeping Angels.
Blink works better.
Do you know what I think would have worked better?
What?
Don't blink.
I think...
It's a bit more on the nose,
yeah,
but
I think they deliberately didn't call it that.
So
why? I think they deliberately just shortened it to blink.
Why?
I don't know, because I think it's more about the blinking than, like, don't blink. Because they make a point of that throughout the episode.
To not blink.
Yeah. I don't know.
Yeah, but
wouldn't
that make more sense if they're emphasising that?
Maybe. I think blink just sounds better.
It sounds better, but it isn't. Anyway, Series 4, Voyage of the Damned, Starship Titanic.
Yeah, that works.
But I think Voyage of the Damned is more melodramatic, and I think that works for what the story's going for.
Yeah, I don't think they wanted to put Titanic in the title either.
Yeah.
For obvious reasons.
Forest of the Dead, could've been called The Doctor Runs, or Forest of the Night, or Rivers Run, or Return of the Dead. Science in the Library doesn't seem to have any working title.
Okay.
Midnight could have been called Crusader 5 or Crusader 50. Midnight's a cooler title.
It is a cooler title.
I think Russell T. Davies probably thought, what's a cool name for a story? Midnight.
Yeah.
How do I fit it in?
Because I think
it doesn't need to be set.
Yeah.
During that time, I'm just going to name a planet that.
Yeah, because when you go into it, it gives nothing away. You're like, midnight. Okay.
Because it still works, because
yeah.
It's about... It gives mystery to the planet.
Yeah.
A mystery I don't recall.
Psychological,
yeah.
Character piece.
And it means that if you're awake at midnight, you don't know what's going to happen.
Fuck. Tell me when I guess whatever, by the way.
Oh, okay, we're like 15 minutes in.
Okay.
To us. Because I saw 47 minutes and I'm like, what? Then
yeah.
I realised I didn't pause the recording.
Yeah, that's okay.
2009 specials. Next Doctor could have been called Court of the Cyber King. But clickbait. And The Wars of Mars, because it was originally going to be a Christmas special, Red Christmas.
Yeah, I've heard this one, I've referenced this one before.
The End of Time could have been called The Immortality Gate or The Final Days of Planet Earth. I feel like The Final Days of Planet Earth would have been a good title, but it's not catchy, so The End of Time.
Yeah.
Because calling it End of Days, that's what Torture did.
Mm-hmm.
So... And calling it The End of the World, they would have
Can't do that.
And in The End of Time... Makes no sense about what the Time Lords are actually doing, but it does emphasise time... I mean, maybe it's like End of the Time War.
It's also the end of the time with the 10th Doctor.
And the RTD man.
Yeah. Pretty much he'd used all of his end-off titles and was like, fuck, how do I make it epic and tie it into Doctor Who? Time!
Now, Series 6... Impossible Astronaut could have been called The Year of the Moon.
Which I don't mind.
The Impossible Astronaut. Not Day of the Moon. Impossible Astronaut could have been called The Year of the Moon.
Oh.
Day of the Moon could have been called Look Behind You.
Okay.
I guess that makes sense because of the silence.
Yeah.
Curse of the Black Spot could have been called Siren, but I kind of like that it's just called Curse of the Black Spot.
I do as well, it sounds like a proper classic.
It's like a B-movie.
Yeah.
And that's kind of the vibe it's going for. Doctor's Wife could have been called The TARDIS Trap.
Okay, that works.
The House of Nothing.
That's also cool.
Sounds like a real Neil Gaiman script. Or Bigger on the Inside, which is my favourite of the three. Because okay, the other two sound cool.
Yeah.
That last one makes the most sense for what the story's main
deal
is.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah.
But clickbait.
I feel like Bigger on the Inside's clickbait enough, because we'd be like...
Oh, the TARDIS?
Yeah, we're going to see and save the TARDIS.
But no, the Doctor's Wife...
I guess, but...
Anyway, the Almost People have the title, the working title of Gangers.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Good Man Goes to War, His Darkest Hour, or, and Demons Run. I prefer His Darkest Hour.
I do too.
Because A Good Man Goes to War...
It's just
clunky and pretentious,
yeah.
But His Darkest Hour is also pretentious, but it's shorter. It's...
It sounds better as opposed to...
Yeah.
Like, A Good Man Goes to War. It's like...
Yeah.
Does he really go to war, though?
Yes, he does. That happens within the actual episode.
He doesn't really, though.
The war's over pretty quickly. If anything, you could have called this The Doctor Falls, but His Darkest Hour...
Yeah.
...works because it encompasses the whole episode. Stephen... No. Night Terrors. What Are Little Boys Made Of? And House Call. Night Terrors is the best title. Because the boys...
I think House Call is quite a good title. But Night Terrors...
Night Terrors works better, though.
Yeah, Night Terrors...
Because it's about...
Well, Night Terrors ties into the doll stuff and all that.
Yeah. But it's... Mm-hmm. But that's also the reason why the Doctor's there in the first place.
I think House Call works quite well as well.
Probably. It works quite well, but I think Night Terrors works better.
Okay.
The Girl Who Waited could have been called The Visitor's Room, or The Visiting Hour, or Kindness.
Kindness would have been cool, but the focus should be on
Amy and Rory. But I think The Woman Who Waited would have been a better title.
Yeah.
Because at this stage of her character development.
Maybe.
Because she's not the little girl who waited for the doctor, she's the woman waiting for her husband.
I suppose.
Also, she was there for like 30 odd years.
Yeah, but reference in it.
But the reference is still there, because it's still the same phrasing, it's just you're swapping one word out.
I know, yeah.
Yeah, that's what I would have called it. Now, closing time. 3 Cybermen and a baby!
The thing is, so that would have completely captured the feel of that episode.
Yeah. I like that.
Yeah, that almost works perfectly.
Yeah.
Because it's a fucking shit Cyberman story.
It's a romp.
Take himself seriously.
Yeah. Yeah, and it would have made you remember the Cybermen were fucking in it. Yeah. The Last Adventure is also something it could have been called.
Yeah.
Because it's the Doctor's last adventure before dying.
Yeah, I wouldn't have liked that though. It's too pretentious. And The Last Adventure exists.
Series 7. A Town Called Mercy could have been called The Gunslinger or Mercy. Also, it's funny because The Gunfighters was nearly called The Gunslingers.
Yeah.
So that's funky. The Power of 3. I'm a maths boy, so this will be fun. Cubed.
I like that.
Because you know what cubing is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cubed is the 3.
Yeah. Instead of multiplying something by itself twice,
yeah.
It's by itself 3 times. I prefer The Power of 3, though.
I think...
Because the emphasis is on the protagonists.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, because it is more.
But either way, it's... Because Cubed would have focused on the cubes.
No, the
Power of 3 focuses on both, actually. Because it's a double entendre. Because it's a pun. Because if you take something to the Power of 3...
Yeah.
You're cubing it. Cubes.
You're right.
Yeah, it's a better title.
I think either or would have worked, because cubed is the same thing, essentially. You'd just be...
Yeah, but the power of 3 shifts the focus on primarily onto...
True.
Yeah, but cubed... I don't think cubed and think of the fucking 11th Doctor Amy Rory.
It just depends how you break it down. You can either break it down this way, or you can break it down that way.
Because Power 3...
Both of them mean the same thing.
They both mean the same thing in a literal context, but in the context of the episode. Power 3 focuses on the main TARDIS team dynamic, and that's...
Yeah.
And that's what the episode's about. And...
I'm not saying it's a bad title, I just think both are good titles.
They are both good titles, and they're both kind of meaning the same thing.
Yeah.
But I think Power 3 is better.
Mm.
The Angels Take Manhattan, The Angels Wept. Get it? Because they're weeping angels.
Yeah.
Hyde could have been called Phantoms of the Hex. This one you may have heard of. Nightmare in Silver could have been called The Last Cyberman. In fact, I think, because of the person who left it on the fucking taxi or something.
What?
Oh yeah, someone left the script in a taxi. Series 8, Robot of Sherwood could have been called Robots of Sherwood.
Yeah, I remember that, but it's because they had to cut out a scene though, because wasn't the sheriff supposed to be a robot?
Yeah, but there were other robots there!
I know, it didn't make sense, but he was supposed to be, like, the primary role. Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, but that would make more sense to call that Robot of Sherwood, but removing that just...
it doesn't make any sense.
In the Forest of the Night could have been called Child's Play.
I like that, but it would be kind of misleading because it's a good title.
And then Dark Water could have been called The Gates of Paradise.
I prefer Dark Water.
Why?
It's just a better title.
But why, Alex? Gates of Paradise.
Because you focus on the Dark Water.
The Gates of Paradise means you're focusing on the afterlife, which is more the focus of that.
I think...
I never got that the Dark Water was meant to be the prime focus of the story. Because the more you focus on it... if you're an adult watching the show, you're probably thinking, it makes all synthetic material invisible, but leaves organic material. These are skeletons. I also know the Cybermen are coming back. Gee, I wonder what it is. You know, but focusing on the afterlife means, Gates of Paradise. Okay, afterlife.
I guess, but the next one's then called Death in Heaven.
Yeah. Well, you get to the gates and you fucking die.
Yeah, I feel like both of them would have been too much.
It's about the afterlife.
But
this is why individual episode titles are kind of dumb. This is why you should just name something one thing. And then Chris Chibnall does both. I don't get it. Series 9, we're nearly done. Under the Lake could have been called Ghost in the Machine.
There was a little
Ghost in the Machine.
Yeah. Under the Lake's cool as well.
Sleep No More could have been called The Arms of Morpheus.
That works.
And Face the Raven could have been called Trap Street.
That works too.
Yeah.
I do prefer all their the titles went with them.
Yeah. Series 10. Here's one that both of us and maybe you all would also know. Pilot.
Star and Mariah, right?
Exactly.
But then I hate the reason that they didn't go with it though, because I thought they were deliberately doing it because, you know, stars in her eyes or something.
Yeah.
But the reason they didn't do it was because Stephen Moffat was like, it sounds too much like that show. I was like, what's the point?
Yeah. And then it's like, I'm just gonna call it The Pilot.
Yeah.
Because it's like a pilot. There's also a pilot. Oh, so clever.
It's clever because it's his last season, but it's also, like, brand new.
But it's a good season.
Yeah,
It's the best. It is his best season.
Well, to be fair, it has a double meaning, because obviously the pilot is.
Yeah. And then Knock Knock could have been called The Haunted Hub.
Oh, my God.
I feel like Knock Knock was a Stephen Moffat thing, like, Knock Knock, who's there? Doctor. Doctor who?
Knock Knock's a better title. It's more, it sounds like a horror.
Yeah. And The Haunted Hub. I could literally just do this TV spin-offs.
Let's not do that, because it's already like...
There's not many.
Okay.
We said we weren't going to do it, but now we're going to do it, because I realise, there's not much of this page fucking left.
Okay.
So, Kanan and Company. There's only one episode of that, and we know the working title of it. So, A Girl's Best Friend is the title of the episode,
yeah.
But the working title could have been One Girl and Her Dog.
Yeah, that's not a good title.
A Girl's Best Friend is an inspired title. Torchwood, with Series 1, Day 1 could have been called New Girl.
Alright.
Same sort of deal. and Miracle Day. The episode called The New World could have been called Miracle Day.
Okay.
You can see where they, what their line of thinking was. Just turning it into a sort of thing like Children of Earth.
Yeah.
And Miracle Day is what the whole thing centers around.
I bet they should have done that.
Yeah. Or just called it Miracle Day.
Yeah.
I feel
like Miracle Day.
Yeah, but the whole series is under this one storyline, so calling the whole series Miracle Day.
I would just call it Miracle Day, Day 1, Day 2, Day 3.
Alright, yeah. So Miracle Week.
I guess, but I mean it takes place over, like, a long time.
You could have just called it The Miracle.
Yeah, sure.
So Class has two. For Tonight We Might Die could have been called The Prom.
Yeah,
I remember that. Yeah, we both remember. And the coach with the dragon tattoo could have been called Skinned.
Okay,
which makes sense. Working titles for novels. So, Cat's Cradle Cat's Cradle Warhead. It's a bit of a mouthful. I mean, first of all, Mark Platt was originally wanting to adapt his unused TV script, Cat's Cradle.
Yeah.
But then he couldn't, like, call it that. But because Peter Darvill Evans really liked the name Cat's Cradle, he made it so that there was a loose trilogy of stories that were all under the Cat's Cradle moniker. And Warhead by Andrew Cartmell could have been called Cat's Cradle Escape.
Okay.
Love and War, which I'm sure you've heard of,
yeah,
could have been called Heaven. Because I'm pretty sure that's the name of the planet.
Okay.
No Future could have been called Anarchy in the UK. I'm trying to... No, I'm thinking of Just War, never mind. Set Piece, that's the one where Ace finally leaves. Because remember, she comes back and she leaves, spoiler alert, for like 30-year-old books.
I'm not too familiar with the books and what happens in them.
Set Piece could have been called Butterfly Wings. Which... Okay. This is more so for the benefit of the audience. Toy Soldiers, which I think is a sequel to Conundrum, which is a sequel to The Mind Robber. I think was going to be called Toy Solstice. Then Return of the Living Dad would have been called Big Trouble in Little Chalfont.
Okay.
And then audio stories, Kaldor City! Because this isn't just Big Finish we're talking about, Kaldor City. Hidden Persuaders could have been called The Rhubarb Conspiracy. A Gallifrey audio called Forever. I think I've heard that one. Yeah, I have heard that one. It was originally going to be called Gallifrey Eternal. Forever is about, a fascistic Gallifrey. Like, because they go into alternate universes in that box set. Alternate timelines. Or timelines that just... were kind of like almost erased or something, like, or timelines created by experiments on Gallifrey, and Forever has them land in a fascist Gallifrey.
So where... Gallifrey?
No, that's Tory! Well, what's the difference nowadays?
Yeah.
But you know, they're flat out fascists.
Mm.
And the only Warmaster one on here, which I'm surprised there's only one, because Anti-Genesis had its whole episode lineup renamed.
Oh, right.
But the Heavenly Paradigm, which is the one we're going to end this video off on, was going to be called The Unutterable Hell of 24 Marigold Lane. Makes sense. Bit of a mouthful, though.
Yeah, it is.
So the Heavenly Paradigm is also pretentious sounding, but it sounds RTD. I was surprised that that wasn't already RTD lore.
Mm. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah. But then they tied it in with the whole Chameleon Arch, and yeah.
It's cool. Listen to Warmaster if you haven't.
It's good. We just spoiled the ending of box set one, but that's box set one.
We didn't give away too much. We didn't say what it did.
I mean, I kind of did.
Yeah, you kind of did. But it's fine. You didn't have all the charm of the Jacoby.
Jacoby, just listen to it and then you'll be like, Papa Jacoby, I'm going to spend all my hundreds of pounds on you.
Yes.
That was nothing to do with the video. Subscribe to whatever channel this is on and the other one.
Yes.
I've been not Jean-Luc, he's been not Matt. Oh no!